Girl, my book is so interesting. How's yours?
Oh yeah, this book is so good. I'm so happy that this library has some new upgrades.
What? A new lunch area, a new gaming area, and a community service hours program.
And we do giveaways every month.
And this year's theme is New Year, New Me. Follow them on Instagram for the latest updates at Broncos Library. What happened, girl?
I've been missing too many days of school.
I hope it's not that many, because you know you could get an NG.
If I do get an NG, how can I recover it?
Well, you have to attend Saturday Success Academy. But first, you have to have a parent-teacher conference with Ms. Clark, Mr. Coakley, or your school grade counselor. But if you attend without a parent-teacher conference, it won't count towards your NG.
So when does Saturday school start?
February 2nd at 9 a.m. sharp. If you have any questions or concerns, please reach out to Ms. Young or Mrs. Clark. Girl, you know Decca selling candy grams and bouquets at lunch?
Yeah, it's on February 5th to the 10th, and you better get me one.
She better hope she get one.
Damn, my cousin is really looking for some community service hours right now.
For real? Oh, Decca doing this thingy where they accept the individually wrapped Valentine's Day candy.
How does that work?
Well, for every $5 she spends on Valentine's Day candy, they give her 1 hour in community service.
Who could she go to?
She can go to Miss McKinnon in room 527.
But you also need a receipt. Finally, yearbook is on sale now.
Get yours online at yearbookordercenter.com for $60. Our school code is 1494. After school reading is back in session starting February 12th.
Go to room 434 from 2:30 to 3:30.
Good morning, class of 2024. It's Monty. I'm here with your senior takeovers. Seniors, your cap and gown packages are now on sale, so please be sure to order them before February 28th to receive your exclusive student discount. You have two ways to order them, at www.herfjones.com or at Herb Jones Student Center, located in Doral, but by appointment only. Make sure to book your appointments. Last call for senior pictures. Scan the QR codes or flyers or posters around the school to book your appointment. Last day to make the yearbook is Saturday, February 17th. New appointments open every Friday.
Look how stressed I am. Do you feel like life is moving too fast and you just want to rewind? Well, good thing senior picnic tickets go on sale next week. Buy your tickets at Ms. Vincent's office and be there March 20th.
Hey Broncos.
My name is Quenisha.
And I'm Valerie.
And here we are on our bus on our way to our senior breakfast venue. But before we get there,
we're going to scope the scenery out.
I'm here with
Moses.
And I want to ask him a question. What are your expectations for today?
Good food, good customer service, things like that. Yeah.
Are you expecting any specific dishes, like you want a certain breakfast item to be there, or?
I want good eggs. That's all I care about.
Good eggs. We don't care about our eggs.
Broncos. I'm Valerie, and I'm here with
Emma.
So Emma, what's your expectation for today?
I expect it to be pretty chill. You know, nothing too much. Pretty chill vibes.
All right. So do you have any food that you want to see there?
Bacon and waffles.
That's so real. That's so real. I'm ready to big my back too.
You're with Anaya.
So Anaya, tell us where you got your fit from.
Okay, jacket from my mom's closet, corset from Amazon, skirt from Shein, stockings from Mad Rag, and my shoes are from Amazon.
Okay, Anaya, I really like your fit. I give it a good 9 out of 10. It gives.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
Your outfit is cute too.
I'm loving
trench coat.
You know, just a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, now them, they did so good. I swear they ate as soon as they walked into the room. I said that so many times. They fit like, they ate. I swear to God, they ate.
So what would you give them? What numbers?
10.
10 out of 10? As you should. So, well, tell us a little bit about the short fit. Like,
this is the last minute fit. I literally just had to find something to put on.
So, hey, I'm sorry. I shouldn't touch your
It's
I'm
okay.
Sorry.
It's okay.
So hair from Amazon, period. Suit.
Outfit.
Closet.
Purse. Friend from birthday.
Shoes.
Also from the mall somewhere.
Okay, thank you.
Tech.
We're here with
Kimani.
So, Kimani, what would you rate this fit?
Like an 8 out of 10.
Okay.
Why you give her 8 out of 10?
Because it's like the jean outfit is like, it's kind of simple. So, but how she did it, she ate up. So, an 8 out of 10.
Okay, so what inspired your fit now, my dad?
I just wanted something simple, so I got inspired by, like, Michael Jackson.
Yeah,
so,
that's what I was thinking when I
So that's why I got this.
Okay, so where you got all your items from? Like,
well, my hair, I got it from my mom, the womb. This from Macy's, also from Macy's. Everything is from Macy's. And then my shoes, also from Macy's. So, yeah. Okay.
Thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
Day. Big rabbit.
I get her
8.5. Same thing.
Why you say 8.5?
She should have did black net tights instead of the red.
Yeah.
She should have had red lipstick on and red eyeshadow. Yeah. It would have made a pop move.
All right. So what would you rate your outfits?
Must?
Yeah.
I mean. You know, speak for yourself.
All right, let's do you first. Where you got your fit from?
Customized, Forever 21, Dr. Martin.
All right, tight. And you?
Custom made, Dr. Martin. All right,
yeah, they ate for sure. Thanks, y'all.
The Harlem Renaissance should be celebrated during all times of the year when it comes to the contributions of African Americans to the arts. It saw the revival of a movement that showcased African Americans' work in theater, music, poetry, writing, and the visual arts. A time of intense creativity that took place in the 1920s, celebrating African American heritage. Harlem, a black neighborhood in New York City, gave birth to a talented and determined group of writers who decided to use their work to express pride in being African American. Notable artists of the time are James August Vanderdie. He is one of the best-known photographers of the Harlem Renaissance. His comprehensive practice documents a wide spectrum of life in 20th century Harlem, from the everyday to the aspirational. William H. Johnson was amongst the foremost painters of African-American life during the Harlem Renaissance. He was known for his expressionist landscapes and portraits. He adopted a self-consciously vernacular style marked by vivid colors and flat, distorted compositions, looking to African sculpture and African-American models for inspiration. Adelaide Hall's wordless rhythm vocalizing introduced what we know as scat singing. Hall made her professional debut as a chorus member in Shuffle Along in 1921, a musical which helped establish African American show business. These are but a few of the countless African Americans who have made the arts in this country some of the greatest in the world.
Good morning, Broncos. My name is Artavius. I'm here with your sports announcements. Our girls soccer team competed for their first district championship in school history. Even though they lost, they still qualify for state regional playoffs. Because of this amazing record, this year, also our first in school history, they'll go on the road February 13 as they take on Archbishop McCarthy. Broncos track team is looking for 10 volunteers for our home meet. Students will receive community service hours, and also today we'll have our orange versus blue scrimmage at 3 p.m. Come out and support your peers. Food trucks will be on site also.
What's up, Broncos? It's Denaya.
And I'm Leanna, and this is
We Got Food at Home. Stay! So today we're going to show y'all two Valentine's Day recipes.
Okay, so Naya already poured some, and she's gonna pour some more. And all you need is just to add some water. So she's gonna add some water, and then you can get, look at a whisk, because that's how we chew it.
Oh. I mean, a whisk and a fork does the same thing. Okay, and so then now we're gonna add some of the food coloring. We have red food coloring, and so it's kind of like, you know, have it be very,
you know,
Valentine's Day-ish.
Oh, it's gonna be pink, I think.
Yeah, it's gonna be so cute. Red,
but... Ooh, guys, look how cute. Korean. Thumbnail.
You have been promoted.
But now you have been promoted.
Okay, guys, so next we're just gonna start frying the batter. So Naya is going to put
Naya!
Okay, so right now what okay, so right now what Naya is doing, she's just battering the cake, and then she's gonna add it into the oil very, very safely. Right?
Very, very safely.
Very, very look, guys. Wow.
And so then you do that like over and over with how many ever pieces you feel is necessary, and then after that we're gonna decorate it.
Ta-da!
Will you be mine?
Yes.
So then we made our fried red velvet cake along with some funnel cake. So now we're gonna taste test it.
Oh, it's good.
And then the funnel cake, we already had that off screen, so it's really good.
It's good. I like
it. Try it at home. Bye, Broncos.
Good morning, Broncos. I'm Amy, and I'm here with
Mix Dufo.
And we're here with the staff highlights. So, how long have you been here?
I've been here since about September.
September? Okay, how are you liking it so far?
I like it a lot here.
A lot? Okay, yeah. Okay. Hey, Broncos, yeah. So what is your special, like, your medium?
My favorite art medium, I think, is photography, but I do like to do all sorts of visual art. I also like music, so I like to talk a little bit about, like,
both.
Yeah, like, okay. Incorporate music, get people to think about different mediums, and, like, not just talking about rhythm and visual art, but rhythm and music and how those are connected, things like that.
All right, thank you so much. It was nice talking to you, and I hope you have a great day.
You too, exit one.
Ayo!